Welcome, Maroon Devil fans, to another evening of Maroon Devil Soccer here at Swain Memorial Stadium. This is Joe Holt. I'm here with Kylie Pond. Hey, Kylie.
Hey.
So we're hosting the Andrews Wildcats here, and the most interesting thing about this match for tonight is what, Kylie?
That they are down three players, so now it's going to be an 11-9.
Which is actually not the best way to start a match.
Definitely not. I wonder what happened to those three players.
So we just did kick off, and it was a throw in for Swain. This is a good opportunity for Swain to settle things down and get some good passes and good touches and just work on fundamentals, kind of like a...
Ooh.
Oh, nice.
Like that.
Yeah. Just need to control it.
Oh, come on, Carter.
Someone needs to come up and get that. Okay, they need to settle and control. This is, you know, with the advantage, they should take advantage with slowing things down.
Ooh.
And there's the first goal.
What is that, in a minute? What is that, 17? A minute 17?
Trey Bowman, who likes soccer more than math.
Oh, Mr. Gray. Trey Bowman, who likes soccer more than math.
All right. Well, they're off to a good start. I think I heard from Mr. Gray that Coach Hampton may start pulling players out if the score gets kind of out of hand.
Which I think is going to happen quickly, especially with, like, their good players on the field. They're starters.
So maybe a lot of our less experienced players will get some playing time.
Yeah, definitely. That'd be really good on their part. They get some playing time, just more touches on the ball, the better.
Yeah, you've got to deepen your bench so that in case you do get some injuries.
On the side.
Yep. Yeah. Shot on goal, but it was hit the upright.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be a goal kick for Andrews.
I was joking around saying that I'd go out there and play for Andrews.
You would definitely be an asset.
A good clear by Andrews will probably throw in for the Devils.
It's like, put me in, coach.
Okay, so we're going to have to do a delay broadcast today because, unfortunately, the live broadcast is not working. Also, it looks like we're going to have to do our own ball retrieving on the field. All right, Andrews clears it out.
Coach is yelling a lot. Ooh. One of them's got a break. Oop. Yeah. Drew's on the inside. He'll probably get it. Yeah. They're about even with the speed, but Drew had him on the inside. Andrews isn't doing not nearly as bad as I expected them to, especially down players. Looks like they know some soccer, at least. I mean, I thought they had, like, a really good big roster last year. Not sure what happened this year with the shortage.
Well, just like with all high school athletics, they probably graduated a lot of seniors.
Oh, yeah. That's what's going to happen with our cross-country team. A lot of them are seniors.
All right, so the Andrews goalie grabs the ball. He's going to give it a punt.
And it is his name?
Number.
I'm trying to figure out the
24, or is that a 34? It's hard to read from up here in the sun.
That'd be a 34. It's Jose Martinez. Wait, okay. Ours?
Yeah, no, the Andrews player was Jose Martinez.
Mm-hmm.
You know, unfortunately, being down like Andrews are, Jose's going to have to do most of the heavy lifting on his own if they're going to score a goal. He's going to have to beat a lot of white jerseys down there.
It'll be good competition for him, though. He'll grow as a player. I go number. What number is that? 15.
Number 15 did the throw in.
That is. That's the one name I don't know. Aramis Hall. Aramis, yeah.
Okay, so it's another throw in for Andrews.
There goes Austin Schuler, captain.
He's all alone.
Waving Carter to sprint up there. Takes the middle. Oop.
Oh, they might blow him on that one, don't you think? If he had gotten it, looked like he got out there a little early. But you never know if the ref will call it or not.
Yeah, especially with the side refs.
Yeah.
We're kind of low on refs today.
Yeah, not only are we low on players on the Andrews side, but we're about two refs down. I think there's just one on the center of the field, isn't that right? Just a head judge?
Yeah, just the center one. I don't know if I recognize this ref. You normally get the same refs from this area. Not that many. I think that'd be something cool for me to do in college. Ref some little league soccer, coach them or something.
Andrews throw in.
There goes Will Ogle. Passing it to the outside.
Yeah, he's going to get called offsides.
That's too hard of a pass. Be a goal kick.
Okay.
Is that Dawson?
I thought I heard a whistle there, but I guess I did not.
He's trying to pass that to Dawson Allen. Not so much communication on that last pass.
No. Especially when you had two players come up for the same pass.
Mm-hmm. Christina goes to throw the ball in on Andrew's side.
So tell us how you know Christina.
We're running buddies. That kind of happens. Soccer isn't as close knit with like other players because you don't see them as much and you don't really... I don't know, cross country, you end up running with them for like 3 miles. So you go like 20 some minutes running up next to them, and then track is the same way. Like you go through that pain, it's like your best friends now. So she's a little running buddy I have when I met at regionals last year, I think. Yeah, last year for track regionals doing the 1 mile. I met her.
Okay, it'll be another Swain throw in. Do you have our starters on the Swain roster?
Swain?
Yeah.
All right, let me zoom in on this.
You could read those off for us.
Okay, we have Aiden Pond, freshman, as our goalie, number one. We have number four, Preston Robinson, as a junior on this field. We got number five, Will Ogle, senior. Number eight, Drew Johnson, senior. Number 10, Carter Davis, senior. Number 11, Jared Southard, senior. Number 12, Jake Pitney, is a junior. 13, Dawson Allen, junior. 18, Yanni Martinez, junior. 21, Austin Schuler, captain, senior. 23, Trey Bowman, sophomore. The only sophomore.
Wow, there's a lot of seniors.
There's like five on the starting lineup. Five and then six, seven. Nah, just six now. Six seniors on the team that they'll lose.
Okay, I guess there was a foul there.
Right over defense's head. And Will's got it. So yeah, he can dribble that out. But now he's got didn't keep it close enough to actually do anything with it that far back. Would have been okay if he kept it close towards him. It's pretty nice how Austin knows that Carter's going to be there, so even if he does miss
here
it,
we
like
go.
He
this is a good.
Did. Ooh, left footed. Nah.
Yeah, just a little off to the left there. The scoreboard doesn't show the correct score, but it's actually 1-0 Swain. Because we scored in the first minute and a half or less.
I think it was like a minute 17, I believe. Something like that. Less than 20. Got a curve on it.
Okay, this ball's last touched by Andrews, so we'll do a throw in. You can hear the Andrews coach shouting at his players. Oh, it looks like it'll be a goal kick. It's pretty warm up here, isn't it?
Oh, yes. Not nearly as bad as the other games.
Yeah, the sun is still up high. We got about another hour of that sun before it drops below the mountains. And it's hard to believe that we've already passed the midpoint of September and it is still hot.
Global warming. Because I remember the years past, like my first like two freshman and sophomore year, my conference for cross country.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to think of the sport I do. It was like freezing cold that morning and we were all like dreading it because it was so cold. And that was like after school, so it was like midday and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And then last year, it's just gotten so hot. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Looks like Andrew has a break, but looks like Drew's catching up to him real quick.
Yeah, Drew's got some speed.
Oh, yeah. They always do sprints at the very end of practice, and he's always like one of the first ones to get back in time. Him, Carter, and Austin, and a few others.
Okay, looks like it'll be a throw-in for Andrews.
Uh-oh.
There we go.
Stan didn't kick out enough.
Oh. Swain throw in.
That was Trey Bowman, yes.
So is Parker not playing?
No. Parker Chatham is no longer playing soccer. He decided to focus on to cross country his
running.
Senior year.
Oh.
Yes, being team captain and pretty much, you know.
Yes.
Coach Parker.
Okay. Well, that's a bit of news for the folks at home.
Sad news, but yeah. Hopefully it'll give him a lighter load with applying to all these big, you know, prestigious colleges.
Okay, there's a swing corner kick and weren't really able to capitalize on it. It's going to be out on. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, it bounced off one of the.
Did it? Okay.
Out,
I didn't
yeah.
see that. It's hard to see in the sun. Okay, settling it down. Let's.
Oh. Didn't really have any. Ooh, there goes Jared Southard. Ooh, goalie got it.
Yeah, right to the goalie. Let's see, who's right here on the left?
The Andrews?
No, ours.
Ours, that's Dawson Allen.
Dawson Allen. Because I'd say the thing I noticed is on that shot, he was right there to pick up any trash if there was any there.
Mm-hmm. A good wing always follows the trash.
It'll be a goal kick for Andrews. Yep, so Andrews will be taking a goal kick now.
Okay. I'm a bit confused on this roster the coach gave me from Andrews. It says that the goalie's name is Daniela Soto.
I'm guessing Daniela didn't make it on the bus.
That has like, I don't know.
Because that doesn't look like a Daniela standing over there at the goal.
No. That's why I'm, like, confused. Because he has the three that aren't here marked. I don't know. Maybe it's Daniel Soto? Maybe it's one of the siblings. David, Daniel, or Daniela. They're all the Soto. Jay's got it.
I hear them talking. I hear the Swain players talking to each other.
Who goes and hits the Athletic Hall of Fame. Goal. I saw that Lauren Schell actually has two cross-country bricks up there, as well as soccer. She has soccer for her senior year, but she has two identical ones for cross-country.
Hmm.
I was wondering how I could get two.
Oh, that was a nice header, but the goalie was there and got it. But that was a good thought.
Not doing too shabby. I'm impressed. Looks like Preston's going to get this. Oh. Ooh, right over his head a little.
Okay, Swain throwing.
Ooh.
Uh-oh.
We're not able to get a foot on it, and they're getting it. Ooh, Will Ogle's getting in there. And right down the middle, no pressure on him. Is Carter wide open?
Oh. It was a good thought, but... Oh, not to the middle.
Preston, get the ball.
And he clears it. All right. Gives his defense a chance to get down there. It's funny, their shadows, looking on camera, their shadows are taller than the players.
Yeah, it looks like that from here, too.
There you go. And it'll be a throw in for Swain.
Aiden looks a little bored back there in the goal.
I'm sure he'd rather be bored than...
than, like, pummeled with...
Like some of his previous experiences. Now, this Andrews team is 0-3, if I remember correctly, they played some pretty tough teams so far, at least tough teams in the conference. And they're going to play Hayesville next Monday, if I can believe what I read on Max Preps. So they've got a tough schedule up to now. And they're actually holding their own pretty well for considering that they're down several players.
Down at least two. I mean, they're only down one goal. They're holding it. Only had like a few shots, like three, maybe four. Two legitimate like shots that were actual threats that the goalie had to get.
Mm-hmm.
I am impressed. Especially since some of them have no soccer experience whatsoever. Doing quite well.
All right, we're going to do a corner kick here for Swain. Oh. I think he was trying to bend it.
Bend it like Beckham.
Or he pooched it, I guess. Maybe he just caught it. You know, sometimes you wish you could take those back.
Ooh. Didn't so much settle that. Like, I bet he would have liked to.
That's a nice pass there. A little overhead pass.
Yeah, him being a wing, he couldn't do that. He needs to run up the sides and cross it in once everyone else goes with him. A little too early trying to get rid of it. Good settle by Drew.
There we go. Oh.
Ooh.
That was a nice move. Okay.
Wow.
See if anybody going for it? No.
He's looking up here.
I don't know if I would really call that a shot. Just maybe a little bit of an errant pass.
Yeah. Because I can only do that, like, a cut over with, like, the outside of my foot. He literally just, like, pulled it behind him, straight behind him, right where he came from. That was really good.
That was a cool move.
He's been working on those a lot this season.
I think I would have been on the ground if I had tried that.
Ooh, 3-on-1. It may be down 2 players, but they get on as quick.
Yep.
Andrew's going up from defense.
There we go. Okay.
Save it.
Oh.
He's got the right idea. He's just got to get it in there.
Just need to hustle up and redirect it back to the center.
Yeah, it looks like he sort of lost his footing from trying to chase it down too much.
Well, sometimes when you put on those afterburners, yeah, your fine motor skills kind of take a hit. Oh, looks like it'll be our throwing.
It looks like we have our other two refs as well.
Oh, they finally show up. Oh, now it would be interesting as if a couple players for Andrew show up.
That would be great.
All right, so we blow the whistle.
Yep. Looks like he's telling the side ref what's going on. Yep.
Okay.
Looks like they're getting the new ones in.
Yep. The ref shakes the junior ref's hand as he takes the flag.
Kind of looks like he was a side ref. Oh, wow. Ooh. I bet they raced over from some other game.
Probably.
That's happened once to us on the girls' team. I think the newspaper is here. Ooh.
Wow, look at the shadows now.
Oh, gosh. They're like big old trees.
All right, we're doing a substitution. Who's coming in now?
Dawson Allen's leaving. And Jake Pitney is coming, I believe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Jake Pitney. All right.
This is a good wing. Hopefully they'll know he's over there this time. Especially now that they got time to think. There goes Yanni Martinez. Ooh. Ooh, she gets the ball. He tries cutting in front of her. She almost had it.
He clears it. Okay, so it'll be a throw-in for Andrews.
I do miss playing against the guys indoor and stuff, like the co-ed. Now that there's an actual girls team, it's not that competitive. Because then the guys were like, I don't care, you're a girl, I'm still going to beat you.
Oh. Pass to the back.
Ooh. Oh. Ooh, look for the pass.
Get away from
the Andrews players
in
the middle. Because it's not like they don't have time to look around and just kind of fiddle around with it. He just kind of stopped it for the Andrews. There you go, Will. The Andrews player is really keeping
That was a great pass to the Andrews player. Here we go. Got to win that.
Yeah, let Preston get that save with him. Yeah, Drew's got it. Oop, on your back. There you go. Ooh, no. The passes are not connecting quite as well as they were in the beginning.
No, they're not. Seems like Andrews is kind of getting into a rhythm of just making things difficult for the Devils.
Yeah, one thing I noticed from playing like a not so leveled team as you are, like not at the same level as you, is that you sometimes go down to how they play.
Oh.
Ooh. Almost made it in.
Yep.
If it had been like an inch over to the right, it would have bounced off the pole in, probably. Goes Drew Johnson in the center.
Okay. Oh, they need to talk.
They're like, you got it. Oh, no, neither of us got it.
Here we go. Okay.
Ooh, offsides, yeah. Oh. Just a little behind the last defender and in between the goalie. Just offsides. Only 16 and a half minutes left. Looks like they fixed the scoreboard.
Oh, okay. You know, I am shocked that it's not a higher score.
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of glad. I mean, I'd feel bad if I were playing on there. I mean, I am swaying, but I'm not playing. If I, like, mercy ruled them. I feel like that'd be a little mean, especially since they're down players. I'm too
right.
nice for that.
Well, but you also, you know, I would think if you scored two or three in the first half, that'd be okay. I mean.
Ooh. Ooh. Almost saved it. Almost just kicked it in the wrong direction. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but right now, because of stats and everything, I think they go off of goals as well when it comes to playoffs. Like if you're tied with another, what is it called? Conference team.
Right.
So, like, we were almost, if we had won that one game last season against Highlands, we would have been tied. And so we would have had to go to how many goals did you score against each other?
Right.
To see if you were truly tied.
Okay, Swain throw in again.
So they're going to want to get as many goals to catch up.
Right, especially since I think we have, what, three on the season?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that was. Okay, across the field. Pass, good.
Ooh, dribble it up. Ooh, crossed it in. Oh. Ah.
Oh.
Didn't quite get it.
A beautiful cross by Trey Bowman. Comes up just wide. Carter Davis is now a goal kick.
All right, so Andrews will do a goal kick.
The key is to get underneath so you get some air and it gets right over the defense's head. Like that. I normally hit it around 30, 35.
Hayesville's last week's, what was that, Wednesday, wasn't it? Last Wednesday
yes.
at Hayesville, their goalie had a leg. I don't know if it was their goalie that kept taking those kicks or if they had another designated player that did it, but I don't remember. But he had a leg, and he could drop it around the 40 yard line on the opposite end of the field, and their attackers would basically just wait and sprint out, and sometimes they get called for offsides, but a lot of times they didn't, and they got themselves in a one-on-one situation with our goalie, and it was that's one of the reasons why they scored so well.
Oh.
All right. So about 13 minutes or so. Let's see if they can put a drive together here.
Trey can't seem to keep those in. Oh, is he going to take it? Yeah, it's just a throw-in, yeah. Okay.
Now, if we had slingshot here, it'd be like a corner kick.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Ooh.
Oh, go get it. Go get it.
Oh, you fell a little. Little Jake.
Oh,
Preston didn't quite angle that right.
That ball had a good bit of spin on it before he kicked it, and then it rolled right off his foot. I can't tell you how many times I've done that.
Ooh.
Oh.
Will, like, headed it into Preston.
Yeah, right into his back. There we go.
Ooh,
oh, nice
drew
move.
The back kick. That was really nice. Oh. And then Austin kind of scooped it around to the other side of him.
Let's see. It looks like it's Swain throwing. And you know, throw in. Still in.
Oh, so go, Cardi. Drew, look up, look up. You can take a shot from there.
Oh, ooh, come on.
I almost had it off.
Yeah, it's almost like the players on the backside of the goal are caught a little unaware. It's like, oh, he's shooting. And, well, at least we'll get a corner kick out of that.
It'll be a goal kick for the Devils. I'm sorry, for the Wildcats. After an explosive start, the Devils had a score at Trey Bowman in the second minute. It is still 1-0.
Wait a minute. I thought the – I must have misunderstood the line judge. I thought he pointed his flag towards the
– Yeah, it doesn't really – well, I mean, the he has a better view of it, but it's mainly – You know, the guy in the center overrules whatever.
Right. He's the head judge.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. It'll be Andrew's throw in.
I see some traffic out on the road. Seems like we're getting more people coming in to watch.
It's actually a pretty good turnout for a soccer game.
There's about 70 people here. I was looking at it.
Oh, so an illegal throw, which is kind of rare at this level. You know, these most of these players have been schooled on throw-ins, you know, forever.
Oh, yeah.
Since they were little.
It's not that hard. Plant 2 feet, throw it over your head with both hands.
But maybe somebody picked the back foot up before they released the ball.
They've called me on it saying I threw it from, like, the side of my head. And it's like, it's just because, like, I'd turn and they wouldn't realize that I'd, I don't know. It's weird sometimes. Oh, another call. It's going to be Andrews. What? I don't have no idea what happened.
It was.
Another bad throw?
It was not an overhead throw. It kind of looked like a basketball throw, you know, where you kind of push it straight out.
Hmm.
It's hard to tell. They're in the shadows right now, so it's really hard to see. There, that was a good. Oh, he's.
He was probably lifting his foot up because he looked like he was running while doing it. Yeah. Who is that?
He didn't drag his foot.
I just chill for a second.
Yeah, well, he's right.
Plant the feet.
He's right there at the.
Number 7.
At the coach's bench. I'm surprised coach hadn't said anything.
No, he's probably holding it in. It's like, how do you not know how to throw a ball? Right down the middle. Come on, Yanni. Come on, Will. Well, yeah, that's Will.
Nope. It's out. Okay, 8 minutes.
Let's see if we can get another goal before half.
Feels like this half is moving rather quickly.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, side pass. Ooh, oh, no, you lost it. You should have passed it. Oh, easy eyes. Ooh. That's so scary whenever they go and you know they're going to kick it, but you got to pressure them. It may just hit you in the face. Oh, looks like Aiden's getting some action.
Well, at least he got a save out of that.
Mm-hmm. And throws it to the 45. Ooh. A pass, but your player wasn't quite up there.
And they clear it out.
Hopefully we can get a good throw in off this.
Okay, so can you see who's doing the throw in?
That was Carter Davis who threw that in. Yeah, his neon shoes.
All right, so I guess it's going to be a goal kick. It was hard to tell who had that last.
Ooh, I see some yearbook staff members getting some picture for the yearbook and senior books. I wish I did that. I did that in eighth grade.
Oh.
Ooh. Okay, good. He didn't touch it with his hand.
Oh, oh. A little
field
hard.
Field goal.
Yeah.
Surprising, because that was around the 20. Around the 20 is when he actually gets it level a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Well, he probably just got his foot a little bit too much under it.
Still in? Ah, went out.
Went out.
Swing throw.
Looks like the football team has returned from practice.
See all the pads and the skinny people are coming in. There's the chuck of the sod father.
Oh!
Ooh!
Oh! It looked,
I couldn't tell from that angle.
not until it passed the goal. It looked like it could have gone in. All right. Well, again, some shots on goal. Looks like it will be a corner. Oh, was it deflected?
Hmm.
That's interesting. I didn't see that.
Looks like they thought it was going to be a goal kick, too.
Yeah, no, it looked totally like a missed kick. And
ooh.
I wonder what happened. Did the goalie try to pick it up or something?
Ooh, pick up the trash. Good job, guy.
Yeah.
I wonder whether their changes are going to be for the second half, players and formation-wise, since this is how the game's going.
Right. I would think Coach would like to have seen another one or two more goals.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Especially with when they're lower, like two players.
I mean, you really have – Andrews has no choice but to play everybody up on defense, and which means there really isn't a downside to being super aggressive at the goal.
Oh, yeah. They're going to be a lot very tired the next half, though. So and maybe they'll get a few goals in then.
Andrews will, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That would have been, like, a great little, like, side pass he made out for Trey, but there wasn't enough communication, so he didn't know in time.
Okay. Okay, settle it. Come on, take the shot.
Ooh, deflected off of Andrews.
Andrews goalie grabs it. Oh. And it looks like it'll be an Andrews throw in.
Oh. Oh. Oh, better get back. Pass up. One out, though. This is going to be an Andrews throw. Four. God. You did it again. He was running when he threw it. Again.
And didn't drag his foot?
No. Oh, please don't tell me that's Asaya. Who is that? What's his number? That's number 7. That's Asaya. Oh, my gosh. He should know this.
Yeah, sometimes you just have a little bit of a mental break and
he just wants to get going. Two and a half minutes left. It's still only 1-0. Carter's got it coming down the middle. Their defense is going back. too hard of a pass that way. Didn't keep it close.
Oh, oh, oh,
oh. Oh, get it, Jake. Get it, Jake. Ah, didn't save it enough.
No.
Looks like they took down two players, so now we're actually playing 9v9.
Oh, are we?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yep. Looks like we'll get to throw that one in.
Wait a second. Okay, maybe I can't count. Let me see. 1, 2, 3. Okay, we're playing 10, so we took one player out, I think. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we're just playing down one player right now. So. Andrews is getting some runs up the middle here.
Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I count 9 on the field plus the goalie 10. Mm-hmm. Is that what you got?
Yeah. So they just went down one more player. They're still, they're only playing 9 because that's all they got. Oh, come on, get your body in front of it. There's Yanni, wide open. Ooh, down the middle to Austin. I'm not sure who that was to. Trying to get it to Carter, I think.
There we go.
Trey Bowman's got it, passes it to the middle to Carter, and Carter shoots and gets it in the right
corner.
There
it is. Okay, that's what's been missing.
30 seconds left, and he got it.
It's a good pass in front of the goal, setting up a shot. Running down the right side.
Mm-hmm.
Passes to the center. And that was Carter sitting there waiting. Nice assist, and now we're up 2-0.
Who was the assist again? I'm trying to take notes.
Wasn't it Carter who...
He shot. Was it Trey? I think it was Trey on the outside.
I think it was Trey on the outside.
Was it Austin? Oh my gosh, I can't remember, and it just happened.
Yeah, we'll be able to review the video tomorrow.
Gotta get those highlights.
Okay, looks like Red will... Andrews will get the throw in. Oh! Andrews gonna get a corner kick.
Ooh, first one. 15 seconds left, though. Better hurry.
Yeah, they better.
That's when he says that he starts speeding up to get the ball.
They better hustle. They won't get this kick in. Five. Go ahead and count it.
3, 2, 1. Beep.
And, all right, that's halftime. The score is 2-0. So, KP, who scored the first goal? Do you remember?
Oh, my gosh. I can't even remember that.
Well, I'll tell you what. We'll come back from the timeout, and we'll hopefully know who scored that first goal and who scored the second. But we'll take a quick break and be back shortly.
All righty. Welcome back, everybody. Just started the second half here. Score is 2-0 for Swain.
Okay, the good news is that the sun has dropped behind the mountain. So.
Looks like we went down a player instead of having 11-9 against the short Andrews. Looks like we went down one player, so now it's going to be a 10-9 this time. So 11. Trey Bowman going up on the side again. Hopefully he gets another shot.
And there's nobody there.
Oop, still in.
He's still challenging. He's really got nothing to lose. Oh, what happened?
The Andrews gig kicked it out.
Okay, so it'll be a throw-in?
Yes, for Swain.
Oh, looks like...
Hopefully.
I guess maybe they kicked it off of...
Oh, maybe. I thought it hit him, like he hit the back of his foot and knocked it back behind Trey, and it went out.
Oh, wait a minute. What are we doing now?
It's a free kick.
Oh, what did we do?
So confusing.
Oh.
Well, Ogle's got the ball. Went up against one defender.
Okay.
And he goes out.
You can hear the buzzing of the lights. They just turned the lights on.
I think it's killing all the bugs on it.
Yeah. Oh, here we go.
Ooh,
oh, a little too hard. Little too hard.
You almost had it, Jake.
I'm sure Jake would have loved to have that one back. All right, so it's going to be a goal kick for Andrews. And a recap, we're at 2-0, Swain. First half, KP, what did you see as far as Andrews versus Swain in regards to the play? Any comments?
Well, I mean, at first, Andrews, I mean, we automatically assumed that they weren't going to do as good having some of their players inexperienced, never played before, and being low players as well. But they seem to be, it was mostly on Andrews' side of the field. They're on their heels a lot, but they seem to be able to hold their own. So with the score only 2-0, they're actually doing quite well, better than I expected at first. Swain was doing really good, connecting on the passes, but like that pass right there, Austin didn't quite make it to Carter. They've been doing a lot of those passes recently.
Yeah, I noticed that. There we go. That's a nice pass right there to the open man. Oh.
You get like one or two of those, and then they get
Andrews. Okay, and then.
Can't seem to keep possession of it. I don't know if he meant that as a shot or not.
That's going to be probably a handball there. Mm-hmm. I think it caught him on the arm. So they'll call a handball, whether it's intentional or not, because if it strikes you on, what is it, from the shoulder down, pretty much.
Yeah. I mean, it still gives you, like, an extra little, you know, lift above them, because you still use your hand, even if you didn't mean it or not. Andrew seems to be able to get away. Carter comes in.
Oh, that's going to get called for sure.
That seemed to be like a weak foul. I mean, I've seen them do worse.
Yeah, yeah. Well, ref's going to call that one. The player falls down. You definitely got an advantage after the player went down. Oh.
Grab it, Aiden. Oh, no.
Now you can't.
Get back. Will's got it. Oh, Will's dribbling it up on the right. Tries passing it, but Andrews intercepts it.
There we go.
Ooh, gets it back.
Okay, now they need to recognize there's three of them there. Oh, a little too much on that pass. Got it just a little ahead of his teammate.
Doesn't have that much pressure on him. Ooh, a little bit too much juice on that kick, and I don't know what Preston was trying to do with that one. Didn't hit it that hard.
He could have just settled it and started dribbling up, make the player, Andrew's player, come to him. I know one thing that Coach Hampton talked about wanting is he wants his players to watch soccer and to actually, he's talking about next year making an actual requirement that his players will all pick a favorite team that they need to keep up with, and
USA.
Yeah. But to, you know, because the best way to learn soccer is to watch it, and especially when you watch good players and what they do. There's so much strategy involved that you're not going to pick it up just going out there kicking the ball. You have to actually watch it work.
Do some homework.
It requires some study.
Yeah, Michelle Lopez, one of our old coach that we used to have for the girls' team, she would always have us come over, and she'd bake the spaghetti, and we'd bring some desserts over, and we watch the Women's World Cup during the summer. We watch it and everything. And I even know some of the former Swain graduates that used to be on the soccer team, they'd actually play some FIFA before they came out to actually play some soccer. So they play it, you know.
Right. Oh, corner kick for Andrews. Oh, no, I'm sorry. I forgot where we were. that would be a goal kick for Andrews. I bet that was fun, especially watching FIFA with Coach Lopez. I bet she added some great commentary.
Oh, yeah.
Especially if the team she was, you know, one of the teams she was rooting for.
Oh, yes. We'd watch the U.S., Germany, Mexico, all of them. Ooh, don't let him shoot. The coach on the other team yelling at him.
Yeah, don't let him shoot. Well,
it's always great knowing that they know you're a threat. Andrew's going to be getting this kick. Got Aiden, the goalie, yelling from the back, telling them they've got this. Ooh, there you go, Austin. Ah, a little bit too hard for the pass right there. Not sure who that was to. It's just being deflected. The Andrews player, like, kicked it and he fell and caught up just enough time to hit it again and fall back down. Don't seem to be pressuring them as much.
You know, for the Andrews player, I have to get my hat off to them because they are playing hard and they're not rolling over, as, you know, it's be tempting to with the fact that you're down and you're down 2-0. But they must be, they must look at this as a little bit of a victory, the fact that, you know, that it is only 2-0 and we're already in the second half.
Mm-hmm. Always got to put it in perspective.
So. Oh.
It's kind of like our recent cross-country meet they had last Saturday. Although we didn't win, but we technically it was a win for the team because we still did better than we expected, beating two big schools. Just got to put it in perspective. We did good on our own. And the soccer team's, Andrews is doing that right now. As soon as it goes out, it's going to be a swing throw.
Mm-hmm. Now let's see if they can put a little bit of an offensive push, get some good passes going, and keep control of the ball without turning it over.
Ooh, Ben Cagle got that ball.
There we go, watch. Cross, there we go. Okay.
Nope. Again, with the long.
Yeah, the big shot. Downtown bombs.
Carter was getting used to them because he can't really take them from the 18-yard line because he kicks it too high just from his natural kick without him, like, trying. Ooh, looks like that hit him in the mouth a little.
Mm-hmm, that kind of hurt his jaw pop.
Mm-hmm. That happened to me once. Ow. Oh, it just hurts just thinking about it.
Okay.
Yeah, Carter needs to. He's not really toned into this game, into his kick. Ooh, may call.
It'll be a penalty against the Wildcats and a free kick for the Devils. Drew Johnson will take it.
Sounds like Drew Johnson's going to take this penalty kick. I did not see. Was it a handball?
I think he was like, yeah, I think he moved him out of the way a little bit because the Andrews guys was behind him trying to get the ball.
Oh, a little bit of a push maybe.
Mm-hmm. Still in. Going to go right there by the 50.
It'll be a throw in for the Dallas.
The field doesn't seem so big when you're up here. But when you're running it, it seems very big.
Oh, I'm sure, yeah.
But it is different now being a senior, not a freshman, though. It always makes a difference.
Oh, see, that went right to the Andrews player.
There you go, second chance. There you go, Austin. Ooh, right there.
Nice give and go.
Oh, good goalie.
Yep.
Good save.
Yep, their goalie earned his pay that time.
Random fact of the day, Buzz Lightyear only got paid $33 for travel to going up to the moon. $33. I just found that out today.
And where did you find that information?
I don't know. Someone's like, oh, you're like complaining about your travel pay and all that for work. And it's like, he only got paid
$33. That was close. It almost dropped in. Actually, the Andrews player made an amazing header that saved that from being a goal. Oh, Austin's nice steal.
Got it. Ooh, nice cut. Quick pass.
Now they're looking get a little. Yeah, let's keep this going. Ooh. This is and then of course off. Then you give it right back.
There you go, Cagle.
All right, and you know those with the ball
join the
football can make
team.
Better passes, but also those who do not have the ball can make themselves open.
Oh yeah.
And I noticed that's something that we're not doing as well, is basically getting open so that the pass can happen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like Austin wouldn't move away from those two Andrews players once he passed it.
Exactly, and then you've got, you know, no choice but to send it to an Andrews player because your guy's behind the Andrews player.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's this one drill I like, and it's like a square. You have each corner has a cone, and you have a defender in the middle, and as soon as you pass the ball, like trying to on the cones, that's where you're at.
There we go. Here we go. Here we got something going on here. Oh, ooh, nobody on the backside.
Come on, Trey.
Oh, but we kept possession. Okay. Here we go, here we go.
Oh, little tap. It's still in.
Is he down? Oh, he's okay.
I just rolled a little bit.
And it's out on... Oh, on Swain, so okay. Andrews will throw in.
That was a really awkward throw.
Okay. Oh.
There you go. Yay. There you go, Daniela.
And Andrews clears it out. Be a Swain throw in. Got about 25 minutes left in this game, match.
Look on the back, as I now just realized that Carter has a brace on his name. Now
okay.
I just noticed that.
Oh, missed. Save it. And out. Okay, so it'll be a goal kick for Andrews. It's starting to cool off a little bit now that the sun's gone down.
It's that fall weather. As soon as the sun's gone, it's going to get really cold.
That's okay by me.
It's just so awkward because it's like I'm wearing long sleeves and a jacket and everything in the morning. Then by the time lunch comes around, it's like I'm dying of a heat stroke. Yeah. It's always awkward.
Okay, there was a nice aggressive move there.
Ooh, come on, Austin. Get that.
Yeah.
All they're doing is stopping it.
Oh.
Drew's got this. I'm not even worried. There we go. Preston's got it. And just kicks it out.
So it'll be Andrew's throw in. Yeah, see, like that pass there, who was that to?
Mm-hmm.
Went right to the Andrews player.
He had his eye open on his right.
Well, I think part of it, too, is Asaya?
Yeah, Asaya.
He went a little too far forward. He kind of put himself out of position.
Yeah, they're not too, field awareness. They're not something
right.
like that.
That's right. He basically ran up ahead of the Andrews player, which means that the ball would have to go through an Andrews player to get to him.
And settling it next to you instead of letting it bop off of your leg. Good.
Okay, there we go. Let's see. I think that was last touched by Andrews.
Mm-hmm. I think what Swain really needs to work on right now, especially seeing how they are against a team, like, not, obviously not as good as them, like, on their level, considering most of them are new. I'm trying to say it in the nicest way I can.
Mm-hmm.
But they really need to work on fundamentals, like knowing where you are on the field, like field awareness, and therefore that'll lead into knowing where your partner is, like your team member is,
mm-hmm.
so you can pass it to them. And they really need to work on the 1-2 passes and everything. It's just fundamentals is really what they need to be doing. I see they do a lot of drills at practice and everything, but they don't so much get the fundamentals in. They do conditioning and some drills, but I don't really see that. That's what we focused on when I was in my middle school league. Speaking of middle school, I heard they're doing really good, our middle school soccer team.
Well, that means that the future is bright. Hopefully those players will be moving up, since we're going to be graduating about, what, 7 seniors?
Six
seniors.
And then next year we'll be graduating 6 juniors that are going to be seniors next year, yeah.
Yeah, so here we go.
There's only like a few sophomores, oh gosh. Looks like they're running a 2. I can't tell what the formation they're running. Ooh, a little outside pass. Nah.
Is that a whistle there?
I don't think so.
Okay, just to throw in. Okay.
That was a whistle.
That'll be a foul of the Devils. And a free kick for Andrew. It is direct.
Not really, since they're from like the 45.
Yeah.
Not even the 45. You have to add on 20 yards because of the end zone. I always forget that. Preston's got it. Good settle. Someone's behind him, though. Better get rid of it.
Okay, who's got it?
Okay, Carter. A little chip for it. Go, Jake. Ooh, goal kick.
Yay.
There's one that went off Andrew. In 20 and a half minutes, and the score is still 2-0. Ben Cagle kicks it up towards the middle, not really specifically to anybody. Okay, Jake Pitney's looking for it. Didn't quite save it, so he could get it, do anything with it. Carter and Austin's running up. Andrews beat Preston. Right through. A through pass. Those are so pretty. They're even more prettier when it's not against you and it's for you.
There's going to be a foul there, free kick.
That's why indoor soccer is so much more aggressive, so something like that would have flied. Just been like, okay. A little aggressive. It's okay. They're supposed to be. Actually, Parker, him and I are trying to look into getting an indoor soccer club at the team. Not so much a actual sport, but like a club time that we can meet up and come up with indoor soccer. So soccer can be year-round for a lot of the Swain players, which Highlands does a lot of that, and Smoky Mountain as well. They do a lot of club teams, and it keeps the team together and keeps them in shape for soccer, always touching a ball.
And where could someone play indoor soccer?
Well, when Michelle was here, we had a lot of people from Cherokee and Swain because it wasn't school. So it could be anybody from like Cherokee or any other school. It didn't really matter what school you came from. And so we just meet together in Cherokee at one of the gyms and practice there. And good save by Aiden. And the only indoor rec center we have around here is by the Racquet Club over in Asheville. A lot of the soccer around here is really focused around into Asheville. That's where all the ABYSA, Asheville Bumpkin, Youth Soccer Association is located at. So if you want to play soccer around here, you really need to go to Asheville. It's a lot of gas. Considering how gas is going right now, it doesn't look like many people are going to be doing it.
Well, hopefully they'll get this straightened out before too long.
Oh, yes, definitely.
But I'm noticing, that was close, but they've kind of stopped attacking as a unit.
More individual.
And it's becoming very individualized. And then passes are going to non-existing players, you know, who are not, I mean, long passes are being made and there's nobody there.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Who's that going to be?
And Carter's going to be throwing it
okay,
in.
Okay, so I guess they touched it last. Oh.
Now that was a good throw-in. If only it went to actually somebody.
Well, actually did. I think, I don't know, I can't see their numbers from here, but the swing player just missed it. They didn't get a chance to stop it, which happens.
It's all about reception. You can't do anything with the ball unless you have it. Go, Ben. He's good. She's good. I hate when that happens. He's like, oh, are you okay? And it's like, no, keep playing.
He's just being a gentleman.
I kind of forget about that stuff whenever it comes to actually playing. I'm a little mean. Ooh. Oh, another bad throw.
Really? Claimed that was thrown. Okay. Well, folks who are watching at home can actually back it up and freeze it and see if they see the foot come up or whatever it is that he is doing that the ref doesn't like.
Apparently, we don't know how to throw. My little seven. My
there
little,
we go.
Ooh, no, get it. Come on, Carter.
There, no.
Oh, went in. Yay.
Okay.
Carter
Davis with his second score of the night.
Okay, so now the swing is up 3-0.
All right, there goes Andrews. Has some type of a spin on it.
All right, let's see. We've got, oh.
Andrews kicked it out.
They were trying to make a passing attack there. All right, swing throw in.
Did Mr. Gray say that was assisted by Asaya? He mentioned Asaya, but I thought it was just Carter.
He did get a pass at the top. I think that's what he was mentioning.
I don't know if you consider that an assist or not.
Another swing throw in. About just a little over 15 minutes left in the match. Swain is up 3-0.
Okay. No, ahead. Oh. Ooh. Ah.
Oh.
Ooh. Hits in, falls to the ground, immediately gets back up. Well, we got that ball. Ooh, Carter doing a quick fakes. Ooh, another one. Wasn't as clean as the other two.
All right. Okay, let's move it to the other side of the field where there's a little... Oh!
Come on. Communication. I don't hear anything.
Okay, Swain will do the throw in.
There you go.
Okay.
Not sure anybody save that and go wide. Go wide. Because you're all clustered in the middle. There you go, Preston. See Trey on the outside?
Oh.
Ah, Trey can't save it. Save it.
Oh.
Yeah, if he was going to cross it over, you had to really cross it over, like, right was then, or else the player got him, like,
right. Was Trey on the ground? Kind of looked like he was, or he was, he didn't see it coming, I think, until it was too late.
He did look a little surprised about the ball going that way.
Are we having a corner kick?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's right, because it went out. Okay. Ooh,
oh,
pick
oh,
up
come
the
on,
trash
grab it, grab it, grab it. Ah.
A great cross comes up just a little bit short for the Devils. And it'll be another goal kick for the Wildcats.
Yeah, they seem like they're a little out of position during the corner kicks. Like, there was nobody on the backside of the goal here.
Mm-hmm.
To
yeah, it looks like they haven't really tried to come up with a set piece for that.
Yeah, Yeah, I mean, and
it's always nice having a pretty set piece. You easily get some goals off of that. It's like cherry picking in a way. There goes Christina. Tries getting it. There goes Jake Pitney. Ooh.
Oh. Keep going, Jake. It's still in play.
Okay, passes it to Drew. Ooh, Drew tries getting it.
Cross it.
Enough.
Okay, cross the field.
That would have been
beautiful. Let's see, did the goalie last touch it? Or did he just let it go? No, I think they're gonna get a goal kick, so I guess he just didn't grab it.
Yeah, I think they both missed it.
Yeah.
Coming from both sides.
Yeah, that would have been pretty though. That's kind of textbook there if that had made a connection there. And there we go. Okay, go. Good settle there. And a little wide to the right.
So 11 and a half minutes in, and it's kind of getting cold.
Yeah, I bet you're getting a little chilly after running at cross-country practice.
I don't even know how much we ran.
Being in the heat, and then now suddenly the temperature's dropping.
It's fall weather for you.
Oh, go, go. Okay. Oh, he's going to get blown for offside.
Yeah.
That was so obvious, even I recognized it. If you are 10 yards ahead of the defender.
Just 10. Wasn't that much.
That was a nice kick. It's got some...
Come on, Drew. Ooh, Christina got it.
Oh. Okay, settle it. Look at your field.
Oh, come on, Trey. You gotta get that foot on it.
That's twice.
That's what he needs to be focusing on.
Twice the pass has come to him.
Picking
and he missed
up
it.
The trash.
Yeah.
One pass, one touch. Really need to work on one touches. Because then the two touches, they're easy. I don't know. My old coach, and their old coach, actually, Dwayne Parton, he always focused on fundamentals. If you didn't know fundamentals, then you'd never win a game. Because you can do all this fancy ball trick and all that type of stuff, but it's really the fundamentals. As long as you know those, you'll win any game.
Right.
So that's been preached to me, so.
Well, and any time if you ever find yourself, like, hitting a slump, go back to the fundamentals because you can always work on fundamentals. Even Michael Jordan worked on fundamentals. Dribbling, passing, shooting. All the fancy slam dunks and all that mean nothing if you don't have good fundamentals. It's kind of a good philosophy in life.
Yeah, you live your life off of your fundamentals. I don't know. It just sounds like the fundamentals of, like, a house. That's what keeps the house standing. That goes for, like, anything. It's just a good vocab word to use. Fundamentals.
That's right. Foundation. If you want to build your house taller, you got to improve your foundation.
Now, are we watching soccer, or is this, like, a lecture in college?
It'll be a goal kick for Andrews. So, anyway.
8.5 minutes left. We're up 3-0. Ooh, not that great of a goal kick.
I think the Andrews player that's taking those goal kicks may be getting a little tired. And it'll be another goal kick. I think it's been the same player.
Yeah, it's the same player. It's like he is me right now.
Yeah.
What I was last season, taking every goal kick, every corner, every free kick.
You took all those goal kicks. I remember that.
It's like, I tried teaching other people. They're too scared. What I used to do, especially my freshman year when I really got to do it, because we had PE, it's a requirement. So every day we had a free day on Friday. Coach Outlaw, one of my old actual soccer coaches, he was also my gym teacher, and he'd just be like, oh yeah, sure, go ahead. Here's this spare soccer ball that we have here in the gym. And I just practice on kicking the other side of the backboard of the basketball goal. And
oh,
I just
yeah?
do that the entire period.
That was your target?
Yep. And that's how I got it up in the air. Because I always had trouble getting it up in the air and doing that.
Wow, we got called for another handball.
Oh, my gosh.
They must be getting tired. 7 minutes to go in the match.
They're kind of like, can we go home now? I want some guayabitos.
It's a beautiful sunset.
Mm-hmm. It's always pretty up here in the mountains. Ooh. Good job, baby.
Yeah, good job.
Little toss up there, straight to Andrews. Whew. Okay, looks like Drew's calling it from Jake. Austin's running up the middle, open. Passes it to him. Ooh,
give and go. There we go, and.
Nah, looks like Andrews got it.
And out. So it'll be Swain ball, cleared by Andrews. Oh.
There's one of the rare big semi-trucks coming through.
So who's number 14 for Swain?
Our team, that is Ben Cagle.
Okay.
I actually don't know what grade he's in. I just know his last name is Cagle, and I like his last name. He's a junior. This is his first year, I believe, playing. So I don't recognize him from playing the other seasons. Ooh, Drew, you could have... Yeah. Could have probably passed that instead of just spiking it in her face. They're getting tired.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like right there, he could have probably crossed it back. Ooh,
oh,
Trey.
Good.
Ooh. The goalie's like, no, my ball.
Yep.
I always remember like Little League and everything, where I would be in like elementary school and we'd play like rec league and stuff. They'd be like, get the ball as if it was your last cookie on earth. And so, like, the joke for, like, middle school for SYSA would be, like, get the cookie. You want the cookie. So that's kind of how they got us to go get the ball. I'm referring it as a cookie.
Okay, looks like Swain's going to get a free kick here. I didn't see the foul.
Ooh, powerful kick.
Oh.
Yeah, it went out, yeah. Go make a corner for Swain.
Yeah, so let's see what Swain does in regards to setup. Okay, see where they position themselves. Like, I mean, KP, correct me if I'm wrong, but there's not a rule saying they can't have somebody on that back corner post.
No offsides on any penalty kicks, corners, goal kicks, throw-ins. Ooh, shot. Deflected.
Okay, cleared by Andrews.
It looks like coach is trying to teach them to to get at the 18-yard line and just kind of run in whenever he goes to kick it, which is like a typical like default type thing to do.
Is that what they refer to as crashing the goal?
Yes, crashing the goal. Yes. Good
That's
job.
A Michelle Lopez. I remember she would talk mm-hmm. about that she really harped on that, yeah,
yeah.
That she really wants her players to crash on the goal. And every time she saw one of the girls' team or the guys' team, she'd see them. Oh, there
yes.
it is. That's
just...
picking up the trash.
There you go, Trey. Now he's got it. Yeah, that was a little bit by luck. That goalie had it, but it just swung out of his arm.
Yeah. And that's why you run in there. Can't kick that goal if you're not there. So, well done. Swain is now up 4-0.
Isn't that Trey? Yeah, that's Trey's second goal. So Carter's got two and Trey's got two, I think. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let's see if they can do anything else. And
yeah, let's just see if, you know, they should really focus on pretty passes and.
Ooh. Yeah, because now they're getting, like, goal hungry a little bit.
I know. They should have. Where was that 40 minutes ago?
We love our Swain Maroon Devils. We do.
We want them to do very well.
This is all constructive criticism.
Well, it's not really criticism. We're just saying what we see.
I know a lot of the guys were talking to me in school because they know I do this, and they're like, you're probably talking crap about us, and da-da-da-da-da. It's like, you guys don't even listen to it. And they're like, yeah, we don't. It's like their coach does. Matt does watch this a lot. It helps him.
He probably has the sound turned off.
Probably, I hope. Oh, Christina.
I know I would. Oh, nice pass.
Ooh,
nice pass.
Jake. Ooh, a little bit too hard of a touch. Ooh, crossed it in. Goalie got it.
Goalie was right there. But
ooh, they're saying it rolled in.
Oh, really?
Is that what Drew's saying? I think that's because him and Trey both, like, put their hands up and pointed. I don't know.
Who's number eight?
Eight. Drew in the yellow right there running back.
In the yellow shoes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Drew.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know his number, but I know that's him.
Well, I want to congratulate Drew for being where he needed to be. I mean, even though he didn't get a chance to kick it in, he was there where he needed to be.
Ooh.
There we go, there we go.
Just rolled a little, like, the wrong way around the defender.
Right, but that's looking good. It's starting to click now.
Last 1.5 minutes.
Yeah, last minute and a half, but still.
At least it happened. Next time they can start a little bit earlier.
Let's see. I think Wednesday they're going to Murphy.
Yes, they're going to Murphy this Wednesday to play.
Yeah, that's going to be a tough game for them. They need to come up for that one.
I'll finally be at this away game. I'm so happy. I get to ride the bus over there, which I'm not so happy about because they're guys on a bus.
And it's a long way.
Yeah. It's like, I'll just demand my own seat in the front. I'll just take a nap.
Okay, good. Send it back out.
Oh, we moved Carter to the back. Seems like he got a little bit too excited and pushed him back a little. They switched Drew and Carter. So they put Drew up a little bit to get some goal action. They put Carter back a little. Get his stats up. Apparently stats don't matter that much. I didn't know that. That's what our, I don't know what to refer to him as, the football coach, the athletic director, many things, the sod father.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he was telling us.
Coach B?
Mm-hmm, Coach B. He B.
Oh.
Ooh, he tried doing something there. So I was just like, you know, I'm just going to kick the ball. There goes Autumn.
Oh, nice.
And Carter's guy, he's going to bring it up. Ooh, perfect pass. Trey, you almost had it.
Just missed it. That was pretty, though. That was a great thought. All right, that does it. Again, the match is over. The Maroon Devils win it 4-0. It is 4, right? No,
mm-hmm.
Not 5, 4.
Yeah,
I just want to make sure because the scoreboard has been behind most of the night.
Well, yeah, well, Gray's here doing the announcements, and it's all the way over
there. Oh, yeah, I know. He's have to head over there.
It's a two-man job. He's only one man.
So, KP, what did you see?
I see that they have a lot of fundamentals to work on, but they did great. Andrews, congratulations to them. They did really good this game, being down like the three players they were and having no subs, and they hung in there really well. Even though they're down 4, they still played like they're still tied and all that. Our Swain boys did great as well. Aiden had some good saves. Great goals by a new soccer player, Trey Bowman, and Carter Davis, a veteran at this. So, yeah.
Yeah, there were some moments of brilliance, you know, some great passes, and that last goal was very pretty. And, you know, I know their goalie kind of flubbed it, but the fact is that you got to run in and pick up that trash if you're going to score those goals. And, you know, if it doesn't go in the first time, you can try to make it go in the second time.
Oh, yeah.
So, but anyway, it was a victory for the Maroon Devils. So now they move to 2-1 in conference play. And they're going to be going to Murphy next.
This Wednesday.
This coming Wednesday. And so we will carry that game. It will not be live. It will be delay broadcast, but we will carry that game, and it should be a good one. So if you want to see some great soccer action, be sure to tune in to Maroon Devils Network. So for myself, Joe Holt, and KP, I'd like to wish you all a good evening, and we'll catch you next time.
Bye.